Hello everybody and welcome to another Genshin Impact reaction video. So I'm a little bit late to this. I was wanted to do this over the past few days, but just every single time I went to do it, I didn't have the chance. And yesterday I wanted to do it in the morning, couldn't because of a bunch of stuff happening in the house and especially what happened the previous night. And so I waited until later that day to do it and the exact same thing happened. So hopefully that doesn't put us back too much because I did want to try to make a little bit of progress on this every day if possible. But for right now, at least, we are going back after looking at a bunch of the Natlan stuff to character related things from the past. And this episode will be focused on Fischl's videos. That includes, because I did answer this in a few comments that I had gotten over the past couple weeks, but the way I'm going to do this, whenever a character has multiple videos tied to them, so like a demo, a teaser, or a collected miscellany, for example, I'm going to do all of their applicable videos in one reaction. So this is the first time that we're doing a character-related video that has that. Fischl has two videos. She has a teaser and a gameplay demo. And then we have... Well, because of that, though, that means that the timestamps that you can click on at the top of the description will include a timestamp for the demo and one for the teaser, and then one for the discussion. I'm not really sure. I might mess around with exactly how I, you know, if I'm going to do watch one video and then discuss it, or if I'm going to watch both of them or all three, if there's a collected miscellany as well down the road, and then do a discussion, or if I'm going to do a discussion for every one video I watch before moving to the next one. We'll see. We're just going to kind of wing it here. There's actually some new Natlan stuff that has come out as well, and some other things that people really want me to take a look at that are Natlan related, and Natlan comes out in less than a week. So if I'm going to get to those, I'm going to need to get to them really soon. But we're going to do some of the old stuff first, okay? So, Fischl. This is, I think, Fischl's teaser. It's called New Character Announcement. It was released 4 years ago on the 31st of March, 2020. Holy balls. It has 2.3 million views, and it is, "Oh, Princess of the Immernacht Reich, are your decrees the stuff of truth or mere fantasy? Doubt not the princess once she has spoken. Were the events that took place not witnessed by her own eyes? Does one perceive oneself greater than she?" Okay, let's take a look. Then I get to talk about some official stuff. I was also notified to have captions on because apparently, even though I'm using the English version of the YouTube channel, these are in Chinese. So we'll need to do some reading. Anyways, teaser in 3, 2, 1, go. I have not heard Chinese voices in so long, man. Man, these little animations are fun.
就是如此，罪孽深重的邪龙被我完美镇压。这样啊，不愧是你。小阿咪，该回家吃饭了。Oof.
爸爸，你自己先回家了。不对，本皇女是断罪的菲谢尔，谁是小艾米啊？
Oh, that's it. Yeah, that was over real quick. Man, they had to break the illusion there at the end. Okay, well, I guess we can do... I guess we'll do the other video too, and then we can go back through and look at both of these in one big discussion part. So let's go ahead and flip over to the character demo now. Which, the character demo was released on the 1st of April, so one day later, 2020. Who of the... Is that lives or lives? Who of the lives in the light of day knows of the depth of the Night's Shade. And then German. Did you get that from a philosopher or one of your novels? Is that supposed to be Oz speaking? Speaking of, we didn't even see Oz there, did we, in the teaser? Oh, we'll look at it later. I don't think we did, but... Okay. Character demo in 3, 2, 1, go.
最近的蒙德深邃的邪恶正在表面之下疯狂。
Oh god, Mondstadt nostalgia.
都要动用我的眷属漆黑夜鸦来观测迷雾之后的真相了。没错，跑腿的正是在下，小姐自己是不会动的。观测锁定。
Oh no, it's an abyssal mage.
幽夜净土之名，死入深眠。
What is that bow?
That's a...
She's... Wait a minute, what? Oh man, the classic overload spam. That's
冒险家协会的工资要我明天去代领一下吗？
Wait, that one's over so fast too? Wow, okay. I mean, I know they're only like 60 seconds apiece, these two videos we just watched, but I was not expecting it to be over that quick. Wow, okay, there's a lot of, like, fun little moments in here that are nostalgia-related, which, for those of you that haven't, like, watched my, or ever been tuned in to my Genshin Impact Let's Play, these might not be things that you yourself will understand just from my point of view, though most of you that had been there in my early days will remember what I'm going to talk about. But Fischl was officially, which that's just a running gag that I do for, I can never get rid of that, a character that I played with really early on. She was one of my original party characters, and I combined her in the early days when I was dumb and stupid. Nowadays I'm just stupid, but back when I was dumb and stupid, I combined her with Xiangling in my party, and I used to just do overload spam. I would pop down Guba, and then I would pop down Oz, and they would just blow everything up, and it was so much fun to do back then. So, being that this is about a character, this is about the best place as any I get to actually talk about the characters themselves and my experience with them, if I've played with them, or any story stuff that I've done with them. Until I go around to do that video I've always talked about doing where I actually talk about characters and break down their outfits and stuff like that, you know, and just the reason why I like characters a lot. And of course, with there being a million different character demos on YouTube for these characters, you're going to probably hear me repeat a lot of this many, many a times down the road, since I'll probably bring it up a lot. But since this is the first one, I can really delve into it. So I don't really know where to begin with that. But with Fischl particularly, if I can find... Where does it show her? Yeah, here we go. With Fischl, I'll get all the baggage out of the way first. Playing with Fischl is relatively fun. She's Electro. I enjoy the Electro element in the game. I like Oz. But, of course, I've always had kind of a thing where I like to play with characters as best as I can, and the whole idea of switching to a character to pop their E or their Q, you know, their burst or their skill, and then switch away from them has always been kind of a bit of a hit or miss relationship I've had with that, because in my opinion, I'm not playing with the character if that's all I'm doing. If they're just boosting or supporting or helping with their skills and stuff, then they're not being played. And unfortunately, that's kind of what Fischl always became. Just a character I switch to, I pop her skill, or I use her burst, which is basically just an augmented version of her skill, if I remember correctly. And back then, obviously my Fischl wasn't built up at all, but I did bring her back for my... Was it the Keqing and Nahida party, I think I brought her back for? Which was, she proved to be quite useful there as well when she was used. And of course, I tried to build her up a little bit better than she was back in the day. So playing with Fischl is fun. And she's, of course, a bow user, and bow users in the game have a lot going for them. They can hit ranged targets, they can do a lot of the different open world puzzles and stuff that require you to aim and fire at. So, and of course, I just have a thing for archery. I like that kind of stuff, and the bows in a fantasy game can be really cool, of course. And her outfit, I've gone back and forth on it with her outfit. I do use her newer outfit that she got during was it 2 years ago when she got her outfit added to the game? That's the one that I use. But her standard outfit, I've always kind of gone back and forth with. I'm not too big a fan of it, to be completely honest. I do like the color palette. I like the darker colors and the purple. Purple's a great color. Black's a great color. Her eye is a nice shade of green. The only point that I ever brought up with Fischl that kind of gets a little bit grating after a while, if I'm being totally honest, is just her Chunibyo personality. When that's all you get out of her, and specifically whenever she is in dialogue, like story dialogue, which only ever seems to be in events these days, or at least these days as in, you know, a year or two back when I was playing events that had her in it, they love, and I mean they love, to repeatedly use her idle animation every single time she speaks. And you notice it. At least I notice it. That's about it, though, when it comes to Fischl for me personally. But as far as playing her, she's fun to play. And being that she was around as one of the first characters that I effectively used in one of my parties, she kind of cemented herself as part of my history with that, which is always nice. Now, if we pop back over to this, something I noticed. Now, this is most definitely pure coincidence, but I have talked multiple times in the previous videos about how much I love Harbingers, right? And how I really, really love the Harbinger theme that plays. Like, you'll hear the motif in every single Harbinger boss theme, for example, or cutscene that they're in. Now, most likely pure coincidence, but does anybody think this also sounds very similar to the Harbinger theme, the music that plays right at the beginning here? Ignore the voice and just listen to the music. That da 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 da, that is exactly like the Harbinger theme. Pure coincidence, no doubt, but wouldn't it be hilarious if Fischl was a Harbinger this whole freaking time? That was the first thing I picked up on in this video. Also, thighs. She has some nice thighs. Okay, so let's see. I don't think there's much in here other than just some fun animations. Or was this the one that had the music? No, I think that's in the actual gameplay itself. So I know for a lot of characters, if you want to learn more about their backstory, it's one of those cases where either A, you have to invest time into lore that is not actually in the game, and I already gave my opinion on that kind of thing in a previous reaction. I'm not a fan of that. Not saying that takes away from the actual lore itself, but that I don't like needing to have to rely on external sources to get information from something that I'm playing or watching or whatever. But if that is not where you get character lore, it could be through a story quest in the game or by going through the character's voice lines, for example. Now, if there's one thing I have not done in the game, it is go through the voice lines. Even though a lot of characters, I have a lot of voice lines unlocked for, I haven't actually sat down and listened to all of their voice lines, you know what I mean? And that's apparently a good way that you can hear a bunch of extra information. People have told me this even in, I think, comments in my reaction videos so far. That they've been like, if you want to learn more about this character or that character, you can hear X, Y, and Z talk about them in their voice lines and stuff. I plan to still go through and listen to all the voice lines someday. It's one of those things, it's on my list of things to do. I've just never done it yet. So obviously we've got some some of her Chunibyo personality coming through here, and then this pretty amusing scene at the end where her father calls her to dinner. Or is that her father? Yeah, okay. Which, now, I guess you could argue that my first exposure to a Chunibyo character was Fischl, but the first time I really learned what a Chunibyo was actually the anime Love, Chunibyo, and Other Delusions, which I didn't watch until after I had already been playing Genshin, which I believe the main character in that, Rika, is actually voiced by the same actress that voices the Japanese Fischl. Correct me if I'm wrong on that, but I think that was definitely intentional. In fact, I even remember way back when we started playing with Fischl in the Genshin Impact Let's Play, people were telling me that, but I had no idea what the fuck people were talking about. You know, I didn't watch that anime yet. Hadn't seen that. So that was where I learned more about, like, what the whole Chunibyo character trait is supposed to be. And, you know, it's a fun little trait. It's just one that I don't know. It's not really, I'm not too big on it. I just think it's one of those little things that gets old really quick. And unfortunately, when you're talking about Genshin Impact, this is not meant to be some massive criticism or anything. It's just something that I've picked up on, is that they don't put a lot of details into characters outside of the very basics on the surface level for what you actually get to see and play with in the game, okay? I don't care about how deep and intricate character backstories are outside of the game, but in the game it's usually pretty surface level. So you hear Fischl say and do these same things over and over and over again. All the characters redo their idle animations over and over again, but with how flashy Fischl's are, you notice it very especially. But I remember learning about her, I think that maybe it was in the summer event where you could get her outfit. Was that where we learned more about, like, her family? Because I definitely know that there was a quest that we did in the game at one point that did that, or taught us a little bit more about Fischl's, like, personal life or personal history. But of course, it would be very Hoyoverse or miHoYo to hide that shit behind a limited time event, because they love doing that fucking garbage in this game. So maybe it was the summer event where you could get her outfit, the one that I completed the story on but couldn't do all the world exploration because I ran out of time and, like, our internet died that day or something. I don't remember exactly the full story, but I certainly ranted about it. But I have to say, before we switch back over to her demo video, these little animations are really cool looking. Even if these ones are going to be relatively basic compared to what I'm apparently going to be getting to see later on, this was still fun to watch. I like the little anime-style cutscene that we get, the cool artwork, getting to see all this stuff stylized, you know, being able to tell, like, I know who this is, and it's just fun. It's just fun to see this. I think that's about it, though, for the teaser itself, and then pop on back over here. So the music that plays here, first of all, let me go over that. That's one thing that I picked up on. Is it here? Somewhere in here. Yeah, right here. This music, which is... this is obviously, I guess, Fischl-related music, but I don't remember ever hearing this music until that event I was just talking about, the summer 2022 event. It had to have been 2022, because it was like the second version of the Golden Archipelago or whatever. Now, these two tracks don't sound exactly the same. I think this one must have been a different the other one was a different rendition of this track, but to know again that a track I've heard in the game during an event is a track that in some form existed years prior in the form of a character demo video. And another thing I've mentioned already, and will presumably mention many times again, is that I've learned that a lot of the music that I've heard for Genshin Impact isn't even in the game. It's all specifically tied to demos and stuff. Like when they do those rhythm game events, a lot of the music you play in that are actually from the character teasers or character demos and not actually tracks from the game, which is a shame because a lot of those musics are really freaking awesome. So I'm looking forward to hearing those. But I guess that's how it was for Fischl back when, and then, because I don't think you can hear this track anywhere in the game aside from that event. But I could be wrong. Anyways, so we've got Oz. Classic Oz. I love this shot of Mondstadt, by the way. Just This is so cool. I know this is in-game, but I wonder if there's anything here that's different. There's a little bit of pop in there, I can see. Is Timmy on the bridge? And Mondstadt's much larger than I remember. But it looks... Everything here looks like what I would recognize or remember. Yeah, because up there, that's... There's a shrine there. Over there's where the one of the statues is, and then you run up over here to get to the frickin' wolf, unless you use the other waypoint and climb up the cliff wall. There's Oz.
没错, 跑腿的正是在下, 小姐自己是不会动的。观测,
锁定。Alright. So we get to see her fight here, and she's using a 5-star bow. I don't know the names of all the weapons. You know, I might have played Genshin Impact now for the 1.2 thousand episodes I have, but that does not mean I know shit about the game. Fighting some hill churls with her bow. So do we get to see her? Oh, we really get to see her use her stuff when Amber shows up, right? Probably because they're doing that thing like they did in the Kaya video where they're showing how her element reacts with other elements. Still nice animations. I don't remember the laugh. But then again, I only played with the Chinese voiceover for... I don't remember how many episodes it was. It was quite a while we played with it, but it was, I think, after the Fischl era and before Fischl came back. So I didn't... If that laugh is only in the Chinese voiceover, then I don't think I've heard it. This is cool how they do this, how they just show it. And they don't even go into detail, they're just showing it, but visually, if you're familiar with the game, you know what's going on here. She pulls out Oz, and then everything just frickin' detonates, which is exactly what I loved. I never used Amber for this back then, like I said, it was Xiangling and Fischl that I used together. But same effect, still, fire, electro, going together. And then we see, whoops. What did I do? Hello? Wait, how many more Natlan things did they release, dude? A gameplay trailer and a Natlan preview teaser? Oh, dude. What did I click on? Oh, this popped up right when I tried to pause the video. That's what happened. Okay, gotcha. Or gotcha, one might say. Amazing joke. And that's unfortunately it. So it's still another really short thing. Now, I was told in the comments section that the collected miscellany videos, which obviously there isn't one for Kaya and there isn't one for Fischl, so we haven't gotten to a character that has one of those yet, but the collected miscellany will go into greater detail apparently of the character's abilities, and it's usually, I guess, narrated by Mr. Dane. So we'll see that. I don't remember who the first character is that has collected miscellany. I think it's Chi-Chi, maybe? And she's like one or two characters down the road that we need to look at. But could be misremembering. Though I'm surprised that they're using this bow. Maybe the bow that I'm thinking of didn't exist in the game yet. But you know that 4-star bow that I think you can... I don't know where you get it. It's probably out of the wish system. But the bow that literally looks like Fischl, it's like black with purple lines on it. It's the same color palette. It's the same shape and everything. It's like it's made for Fischl, right? It looks like it's made for Fischl, I mean. And I think even someone even said like, oh, yeah, that is supposed to be designed after her. But it's not a bow that... It's not one of the choices that people choose to go with her. I don't remember the whole story there. Because like I used stringless on her. That's what everyone told me to use, and when I went to rebuild Fischl, I still used stringless. And the bow that we're seeing here, I think, is the bow that you use on Ganyu, I think? But I'm not really sure who's supposed to be using what. I don't know if by... Because obviously this was before the game even launched, so I don't know if they had signature weapons yet. Maybe they did. But nowadays, you know, every time they release a new character, there's a weapon that's made specifically for them, or to be benefiting that particular new character for, like, new 5-stars and stuff. But maybe not for 4 stars. Who knows? I've not actually looked through like any comments on these videos previously. I mean, that'd be kind of fun to scroll down and see what people are saying. What am I in here? Oh, this is the character demo. Okay. It must be hard for her doing a JoJo pose after every attack. For fuck's sake, please. Are you serious? Does she really does that though, doesn't she? Every time she does her attack when the animation plays. That's totally what they're fucking talking about though. This one is, okay, I see. We're doing the JoJo shit. Even Genshin can't be free of it. You've got to be freaking kidding me. Oh, man. Here we are, 1 year later, and she's been announced as a new playable character in Honkai Impact 3rd. I remember when that, when people were talking about that. Obviously, I don't play Honkai Impact 3rd, never have, so I wasn't there for that, but I do remember it being a thing. But I guess that's it for Fischl's stuff. I don't think there's a collected miscellany. Now, in the off chance, because pretty much all of, like, when there's a character teaser demo and miscellany, it is tracked in those custom-made playlists that people made for me. But I'm pretty sure that if... For whatever reason, if it ever came down to me accidentally missing one, like let's say a character had all three, a teaser, demo, and miscellany, and let's say I only realized or only noticed that it had two, and I forgot that there was another one, so I only watched and reacted to the demo and the teaser, and then uploaded that, and then people are like, oh man, you didn't do the miscellany. I would just have to do the miscellany separately. It would be in its own video. There would be no other way that I could do it without pulling the original video and then remaking it or resplicing it together and then re-uploading it, and I tend to not like doing that because it fucks with my stats. So what I usually do is, in that case, I would just upload the original with the teaser and the demo, and then I would upload the miscellany later to make up for it as best as I can. But I don't think that's going to be a problem. It's just a possibility. Anything can happen, you know, when you're fucking around. So that is these two that we've done here. And unfortunately, let me also track these with the likes. That's one way that I'm keeping track of which ones I've seen so far, because once we get way down the list, you know, 100 episodes into this series, it's going to get harder and harder to remember exactly which ones I've seen. You know, by accident, I might try to rewatch another one I've already seen in the past, but if it's got a like on it, that's how I know I've seen it. So what up next is Xiangling, right? And then Chi-Chi. And Chi-Chi's got the collected miscellany, but I guess Chi-Chi doesn't have a teaser. So frickin' Fischl, a 4-star character, gets a teaser. But the first 5-star in this list doesn't get a freaking teaser. Just a demo and a miscellany. And you'll notice the miscellany videos are usually pretty long. Like they're 4 or 5+ minutes each. I mean, you'll see the Keiching miscellany's 5 minutes, Mona's 5 minutes, Jean's 5. In fact, Jean only has a collected miscellany. What? She doesn't even have a demo. Oh, same for Diluc. Okay, it looks like the first character that's going to have all three is Venti. He's the first one that has a teaser, a demo, and a miscellany. All right, so it'll be a little while then before we get to one of those. Oh, balls, man. But although I do find it kind of funny, though, that Fischl and Xiangling are together in the list, just like how they were both the two characters I put together when I started playing the game. But I think that's it for the Fischl-related video. Of course, you can always suggest more reaction stuff in the comments below that I'll hopefully be getting to everything at some point. Natlan was the exception because it was new and it's coming out soon, and I wanted to be there for the hype train with everyone else. And apparently there's more Natlan stuff now that they've uploaded that I'm going to have to take a look at. Plus, there's also that live stream that people wanted me to look at too. Pretty much everybody that's commented about it said, you know what, fuck it, just do it, dude. It's going to be a lot of fun. So I might check it out, at least from this point forward. I don't know if I'll check out past live streams, but at least for the new stuff I might. We'll see. But now I'm going back, continuing the character stuff, and I will probably do a few more of these right now while I have the time and the brain energy. And then later I need to continue because I'm not done with the summer event in Genshin. So, and that's only got like 4 days left. Okay. But anyways, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next Fischl. Wait. Why did I say Fischl? Because Fischl's on the screen, so my brain was going elsewhere. In the next character-related reaction, which will be on Xiangling, the Pyro chapter, I guess. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Goodbye.